Okay, we're back. Score is 4-3 now. Ramin's in the lead. He shot three balls to the side pocket. 1, 2, 3. Had to go up and down table for each shot in the last game. So he's breaking now, and he makes the nine in the side, and it looks like he might be able to get a piece of that one ball. I don't know if he can make it, but and I'm sure he'll. I would imagine he's gonna have a tough time getting to the two ball. So I'll be right back. Okay, looks like Ernesto strung a game together, so it should be even, if I'm not mistaken. I tell you what, not a bad match for your last match of the day. We're going to start bright and early tomorrow at 12 p.m. again with Bustamante versus John Mora on the winner's side. Also on the winner's side, we have Santos Sambajon and Alex Pagulayan. And who else do we have? We have on the one-loss side, Geraldine.
Up.
Oh. Wow.
Yeah.
Vilmos will be playing Edgy on the one-loss side.
Okay.
And Oscar Dominguez will be playing the winner of this match.
The winner of this match. Okay. And so that's four. That's it. Those are the only four players left after this. So those are our top eight players this year. Nice kick. Very nice kick. Unfortunately, I think he left Ramin a shot. I don't even know if there's any reason to go for this shot. You might want to play a safety or something. Because the trip to the three ball is not easy. Yeah, that's what he did. Played safe. Let him sweat a little longer, says Ramin Bakhtari. We're pretty busy, you know. What are we doing? We're packing everything up and then going straight to Vegas.
Oh, not straight.
We're not? We gotta go home first?
Yeah.
Oh, God.
We gotta go feed Poppy.
Oh, feeding Poppy. Okay. Yes, pool. Brazil, hello.
I'll show you censorship. Princess Lamahana. Almost Fulbish. Edgy Geronimo. Sponsor logos back up.
There's a good chance now Ernesto could... it's a three-foul rule. That's right. Three fouls. You lose, Signor Bakhtiari. Ten ball goes down, but it doesn't count, so... However, Ernesto has a great opportunity here. A shot on the one ball, and doesn't look like there's any major problems here with this layout. Nothing but air and opportunity here. All relying on execution. Looks like a hook on the two. Thank you. tweet at him? Steve Strickland?
No, you made the announcement after I already finished doing what I needed to do. Go to that post that I posted. Click on it. Scroll down.
Well, Ernesto has taken a 2-game lead. And there's the swing for Ramin. Here we go. Boy, he racked those balls pretty quick, didn't he? He's in a hurry.
He looks exhausted.
He says, I'm hungry. I want to eat.
He looks exhausted.
Nice break. He's got the breakdown. And I think he wanted to rush to the table because he felt like he wanted to break again. He's got the breakdown a little bit. He broke really well last break, but he just didn't run out. Oh, no. Well, it's wide open now for Ramin. Gonna come to the table pretty happy. This match has been an hour and 24 minutes so far. That was a very well played shot. Very well played. Good execution. Oh boy, nice shot. Oh. And a miss. Well, this is not the hardest out, but these guys are pretty tired, so it's possible Ramin could come back to the table. But at this point, I highly doubt it for this game. Couple of very good shots there by Ramin, you know. Those are tough shots to play.
All right, so here's how this is going to go down. You guys get to go and eat and all cover for you.
Are you sure? We get to go eat.
Okay.
I'm going to separate the shit that I brought for me out, and then the rest is for you guys.
So Ernesto's back, breaking, and he needs just two games to win. Oh, yeah.
A little subsidy for POV. Enjoy.
Try to understand the women and hate each other. Aha. So Truman's going to join you guys.
Try and channel some sanity.
And here, hey, camera 1, 4, 5, 6.
What if I just leave it on one?
That's fine. All just right. 6. Right. Okay, I'll be right back.
Hello. To anybody who knows me, hope you guys are doing well, enjoying the tournament. Ooh, super fast cloth. Howdy, Nathaniel. I don't even like playing on new cloth. Who here prefers new cloth? Hey, Chris. I feel good. Chris is asking because I got tagged by a car crossing the street the other day in Hollywood. I just got to hard time, so I haven't been watching, but if the score is correct, 4-3, then I'm assuming Ramin's playing pretty well. Hey, these balls look new. Nice. And I personally hate new cloth because I don't like the slide. And as my friend John says, he's like, you know, the reason he doesn't like new cloth is, well, he does like it, but the reason he says that I don't like it is because I can get back in line with just a little bit of side spin, and he's right. I feel like it's really hard to control.
Yeah, I love Ernesto's game. I think he has just gorgeous cue ball. Yes, I am blind, Terry. Some of you guys know I'm a computer nerd, and even still, I never figure out how to change the score when I try and take over Daniel's job. Thank you.
can't even pronounce that, Nathaniel. Going to be a little bit of a sharp cut here, hard to control the cue ball. Staying on the side of the six he's on right now, not getting up. Okay. Yeah. This is gonna. It might look on the camera like it makes sense to shoot the seven in the side, but I like it in the corner. It's pretty hard to mess up if you shoot it in the corner. There, it's a good thing he didn't graze it. But now he's gonna have to finesse this one. Hold the cue ball there, but it looks pretty good. Sure, let me see if I can figure out how to raise that. Better? Hey John, how's the volume now? Shot. How is it, you know, whenever it's new cloth, I always worry about skids. Have there been many critical skids today? Nice run up. Sorry, I'm not changing the score. I think the score is 8-5 now. But I don't want to choose a layer and then not have you guys be able to see the match. Yeah, that's the thing about slower cloth, really fast cloth, is you have to hit stuff slower, and the slower you hit it, the more pronounced the skid effect is, I think. You know, he's controlling the cue ball and one ball pretty well. I mean, he got a little unlucky for the seven to obstruct it. Okay, 7-6. Sorry. Score is 7-6. You have to play to scrape it. I don't think you can push here. It's
just not one of those situations where you're going to do too well pushing against senior Dominguez. Just too good at controlling the balls and getting it somewhere that's going to be disadvantageous. Geraldine's grabbing a quick bite to eat. Great shot. I mean, the execution was good because he had so little of the ball to work with. So at least half of what my praise was is for the results. Be easy for him to play safe here, but I think this is going to, whoever gets control of the table first with a good offensive shot is going to have their work cut out for them to run this out. Unless they're going to play the 210. I don't know. I mean, actually, yeah, the 210 looks really good. What am I talking about? Sorry. But if you can't get a good angle on the 210, it's going to be tricky to play. I feel like Ernesto will hit, you know, about a quarter of this ball, split the balls after he kicks it. So he'll kick, hit about a quarter of the ball, come to the rail just above the side pocket, and he might get to use that group of four balls to play a counter safety. This is his wheelhouse. Well. Hey Tristan, that the Mez Q you have, is that the short one? So he's going to try and kick the 10 in, I guess? Or it's hard to read what he's doing.
Got the score.
No, the score is wrong. If you show me where to do it.
Plus, plus, plus.
I got you. So he's got 8, and the score is 8-6, right?
Score 7-6.
7-6.
So I'll just change that to 7 manually.
Okay, score is now correct. Thanks for tolerating that, everybody. Wow, what a great roll. I don't mean like luck, I mean like what a great shot. That's just what I love about his cue ball. He doesn't have to overdo anything. He's just so knowledgeable. This is still going to be a tough rack. I don't think it's easy to go forward, so I'm assuming that he has to... What is he looking to go short side, two rails to try and get short side on the 5? I think it's more practical to hit it with really finesse low inside and go to the long rail, then short rail, and then get back over to being close to straight in on the 5, low inside. He's playing to go to the short side of the 5 ball, which looks hard. well done. Really nice. I have to say I'm sorry for how retarded my commentary is. I'm on the verge of shutting up, but you know, I think I just found the camera angle to look at. It's really hard to see what's happening because you're so level with the table. I'm assuming he's going to draw and try and go between the 10-8. Nice shot. And he's on the correct side. Draw just behind the 10, but don't get on the rail. Can't take this for granted. You got to get good on the 8. That'll do it. This is going to be tied up. Run out. That opening shot was good. It was. It looked like he had to do something extra to get the cue ball to follow to the short rail. But he played it nicely. He might have overcut it. You know, played to the other side of the pocket so he could hit it thinner. Hola, Sandy. This is the part that drives me nutty when I play rotation games. I mean, even as much as it didn't look like a big roll that he could feather the one ball, you know, having that discretion of being able to either push out or try and play safe is a roll. And then when you don't make a ball and somebody else has to push out, that's a roll. These are decisive differences that are not differences expressed by skill but by chance. I know that people like it. That's how it's going to be. Anyway. I'm assuming we like overcutting the one ball past the 5 and, you know, coming back down to the side of the table, maybe towards the 6. Oh, I don't like that direction. That's another little bit of a roll, no? If you ask again later, Pro Satan, maybe Daniel can ask that. Answer that. I don't know. Well, regardless of my diatribe on rolls, who's ever gonna run out here? If Ramin is gonna run this out, he's gonna have to play some great pool. There's traffic. You know, you got 9 balls on one half of the table. He can come just past, he can hit just above the side pocket and trickle down to get a shot on the 2, but he's playing not to get an angle, but to get a shot. So, you know, there's no guarantee that he's going to have something that's workable. Now he's going to run into that. All right. That's what always happens. If you touch a ball on that angle, I mean, you're always going to scratch. So, giant, giant roll. I mean, raised to two, ball in hand. It's a nice starting spot. Even with it, you know, this is a technician's rack right here. This is, if you're just banging balls by yourself, you might run it out. But when you're looking at everything and saying, what is the correct way to play this? Where do I want to get this to make this easy? That's when the pressure starts to pile up, you know. And of course, this is, you know, everybody gets to watch you do it. Well, Ernesto got a roll. And but basically, by Ernesto playing the 210 at such an important moment in the match, he was reifying what I was saying, and that is that, you know, nine balls on one half the table, that's basically like playing rotation. Rotation is 15 balls on both halves. So, three foul looks pretty hard because none of the balls are near each other. And that's still even a foul away before you could even start to entertain that. But yeah, that's what I do on brand new cloth. I cannot predict how it's going to react. If the three goes past the eight ball... Well, actually, the three ball goes in that corner, so float forward. Yeah, I like this. Wow. Okay. And he can shoot straight at the ball. Can you believe? Not only shoot straight at it, but he can pocket the ball, I think. I mean, even if he can't shoot straight at it, he could play the two off the eight. I mean, you got to call the side pocket. Oh, off the four, excuse me. Yeah, he just called the two ball in that side pocket. I mean, I think it's going to come up really short. You got to hit the two thin in order for it to come off that ball, blah, blah, blah. But it's possible. You know, it's not a ludicrous chance that he'll make it there. I think it was Shane who jump cut a ball like 70 degrees in one of the finals here. Sidearm. Sidearm is tough sighting to me. Big shot.
That was awesome.
Oh boy. Wow, that was a millimeter away from losing the game there on a, you know, because that would have been a third foul if he'd had any more follow on the ball. That would have been a loss of game. And I don't think I'm alone when I say that losing a game on three foul is kind of hard emotionally. Traffic, yeah, just like I was saying, it wasn't easy, you know. You have to like play to this part of the pocket and hit at this speed that's conducive to a little bit of masse. You can't like cinch the balls when you're having to like weave through traffic again. Ernesto did get a roll there, but I mean, it, you know, the consummate attitude has to be you are lucky to be at the table when somebody who is a good player comes to the table with an open shot. Yeah, losing a game on three fouls is not emotionally the equivalent of your opponent making a 210 combo. I'll take a 2-10 combo emotionally over a 3-foul. It's possible for him. It's possible for him to kick this ball in, but I would rather play safe here because these pockets are tight. And when you try and cut it that much, you could miss the whole ball. Wow. Nice shot. Behind the 10. Behind the 10. Yeah. That's how rolls go in pool. I mean, not that that was a roll to make the ball, but yeah, you could have left it jarred up in the pocket. And of course, the billiard line of this four ball is straight in that corner pocket. I slept all day today. It was glorious. Yeah, and you can see he had put, if I saw that right, right hand spin on it, which when you jump the ball is pure deflection. It doesn't masse any. So your sight picture, while when you're shooting a ball on cloth, might tell you, well, the deflection and the veer or swerve, whatever you want to call it, are going to neutralize each other. But when you jump the ball, it's on the cloth so little that all you get is deflection. Oh, okay. This is a hard shot, in my opinion. I don't know what to do here. Oh. Jacked up, jacked up, jacked up. Just, if you're not in line, everything is tough. But now he's in a good spot here. And like a champion, he didn't hit it soft enough to where it could have skidded or done something where he'd have had anybody to blame but himself. Ernesto has a strong winner's mind, so he gets down there and I just like his game, man. This is missable, but I think he'll make it. Okay. Big run out. I don't know about you guys, but I really like Ernesto's commentary. He's funny, he's humble, he's very sharp. Great break. Wow. Wow, wow. A lot of pressure here. Because it's all in his hands now. So, play the 4 past the 10 if it fits. Oh, okay. So, that's a good shot, but you know, maybe he can even play this and bump the 5. I don't know if it fits past the 9 either way, but oh, another big roll. Look at that. That is a huge roll. See, that's why I'm not a big fan of these rules. I think the right rules are call shot, call safe. Not shot, call pocket. Right now, in my world, I want to be able, if I were Ramin, to say, go ahead, buddy, shoot again. Unless he called safe, he should not be rewarded for the randomness of the outcome. Daniel's back for all those of you that I tortured.
What's up, Sherman? Still 7? No, it's 8-7.
Yeah. How was your food?
That was awesome, man. Thank you.
Good, good, good.
That was great.
Have you had that before? Is that ramen place?
No,
no. Okay.
No.
Nice shot.
That's a...
He didn't get him?
Fail. The five goes, too.
No, the five goes, but I don't think you can hit it hard because I think you have to graze the long rail going in. Right? It's not a lot of room. I think you got to touch the corner.
No, he's got the whole pocket.
Oof. I don't know.
he's not going to like it like this.
No, exactly.
But he can get there.
I mean... This isn't a cupcake run out.
The whole pocket, Truman.
Whatever. Even the whole pocket's not big, but I mean, you know, the 7 doesn't go past the 9. I mean, this is work. Yeah, Chris, I would give up my ability to be able to play two-way shots over getting credit for my intentions and not being punished for the accidents of my opponent. But I know people who specifically like those results. Like, this was 2-way. You know, you can't deny it. This was a 2-way shot. He didn't accident that up. But yeah, I would rather have to make a decision. You want to play 2-way shots? Play one pocket. Two ways are great, like I said. I get why you would want to keep them. I get why it's a debate, but I'll take credit for intention over ambiguous results with luck having such a huge role. And here, it almost looks like the 10 ball is obstructing the trajectory that he'd have to jump in order to make the ball.
He's going
to
jump it anyway.
I know, but he can only jump to hit. I don't think he can jump to make it.
I don't like jumping this.
Would you rather go two rails and kick it or go one rail and kick
it? He's not going to jump it. Yeah. I'd rather kick this, yeah. Try to bring the cue ball under the 10 again. Okay. I definitely don't like that. But
Well, you don't like the results, but that doesn't mean that you don't like the method.
No, I wouldn't have kicked under the 6. I would have kicked into the 6.
One rail, not two rails. Then.
One rail, okay.
Yeah, no, I agree. But I'm sure that's what he wanted. It's just that new cloth is so hard to predict.
Nah, he was going under.
Oh, okay.
Look at this guy.
He's happy.
Huh? What a smoking shot that was.
Yeah. But he still has to deal with the 10 here. He's got to hit this with magical speed. This is no, you know, again, hard shot.
Ernesto's take. You know, this sucks, man, because even if he wins, he's going to forfeit to his son.
It's okay. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. That's the game winner right there. That was a gorgeous shot. Set winner. I'm sure Ramin would love him to just say, well, since I'm forfeiting next anyway, I'll just roll over.
No, Ernesto wouldn't do that for his son.
I know.
To his son.
I know.
Hey, there you go.
lot of rolls there in the last couple of games.
A nice end for Ernesto. He played a very good shot on the six and then, you know, bumped out for the eight ball with the seven. Great, great performance. And I'm a satisfied customer. Day two at Hard Times Billiards is over.
I'm going to go
Day two,
food.
The Hard Times 10 ball. Thanks, Truman, for hanging out.
My pleasure.
And if you join us tomorrow at 12 o'clock, you just might catch John Mora versus Francisco Django Bustamante. So with that, we want to bid you guys adieu, which means, I don't know, farewell or whatever. So we'll catch you guys tomorrow. Same time, same place, 12 o'clock tomorrow, Pacific Standard Time. And that will be in 12 hours. So thanks again. Keep loving pool. If you want to get on our email list, send an email to Daniel at POV Pool. That's Daniel at POV Pool. Ouch. Just put that anywhere. Just send me an email and say, I want to get on your email list. Put me on the list. I want to be on that list. And we'll notify you guys anytime we have an event that we're doing or a stream that we're doing. Or anytime that we're simply giving something away, we're just going to harass you and bother you and let you know that we're streaming. Lastly, too, another reason for you to get on the list is that sometimes you have friends and family or close loved ones that might be in trouble in the pool world, may have passed away, and it's always... you know, just general news. Okay, never mind. I'm not going to get too much into that. But, you know, we don't like bad news. But anyway, send me an email. And we love you guys. If you don't buy the pay-per-view, please send us a donation. We love you guys. Keep loving pool. We'll talk to you tomorrow. John Mora and Francisco Bustamante. First